Hi, this is Mark from LongIslandWatch.com, and welcome to another episode of Watch and Learn. Today, a little bit of do-it-yourself. We're going to be sizing a Seiko watch with a couple of tools. I've got a standard, spring bar tool and one of these pin vises, and I'll show you how to size the bracelet a couple of different ways with both of these tools and also with a block and hammer. Sizing your bracelet is probably one of the most basic things you can do as a consumer. And probably not mess it up. Battery change, I know a lot of people do, and I know a lot of people mess up the watch as well. Maybe that's another watch and learn. But today we're going to be sizing the standard friction pin watch. I'll tell you what a friction pin is. I'll show it to you up close. And then I also want to show you all the tools that we can use to do it. I'm going to do it three different ways. And then in the next watch and learn, I know a lot of you are asking about Seiko pins and collars. Can you show me how to size a bracelet like that? Because a lot of the Seikos use them. And it's not only Seikos. It's most ceramic bracelet watches use pins and collars as well. So I'll cover all of that in another, maybe in the next episode. Today we're just going to go over the basic fundamentals of sizing the bracelet a couple of different ways. So sit back, relax, and let's check out how to size a bracelet. So in front of you here, I have a Seiko 5 diver. This is the SNZH-55, the 50 fathoms as it's called. And then I've got an assortment of tools around it. And I want to show you how you can size this bracelet. This is a standard pin bracelet with each set of these tools. And like I said, in a future video, probably the next watch and learn, I'll tackle pins and collars, which are on a lot of the Seiko divers, the ProSpex line, and other high-end pieces. So the first thing you need to do, obviously, is determine how much of a fit you need, how many links you need to take out, or how many links you need to put in if you are expanding the bracelet. What's interesting to note on this watch and on many watches is that there is a micro adjustment. You may see it listed sometimes in a listing, in the description, but if you look at the clasp, this fold-over clasp, there's four sets of holes here. One, two, three, four. And into those sets of holes, the end link, or this end of the end link, I should say, attaches. See, it swings around here. So you can move this pin through here to get a fairly wide range. I would say more than a link's motion you can get. So this is good, like, if you're going from summer to winter, the weather's changing, wrists are swelling or wrists are shrinking. This is a quick way to adjust the watch and to get a finer fit than you get with just the links. Not all bracelets have a micro adjustment. The Seiko does. To adjust the fine link, I'm going to show you how I do it. I don't know how other people do it. I mean, this is how I do it. This is the best way to prevent the spring pin that's inside here from becoming Apollo 13 and launching through your room. So you want to take the tip of a watch strap tool, something with a fine point like this, or something like this, and you're going to just depress it. Depress the pin until it goes down. Once the pin is retracted, you can actually just walk it over to the next hole. And that's what I'm doing. And then it snaps into place. So right now it's a little bit uneven, as you can see. So I have to go to the other side and do the same thing again. I push it, it retracts, and then I walk it over. And then it's in. So now it's adjusted a little bit smaller. Now I know people, I've seen people do it where they do it and they take the pin out, they move it to where they want it, and they put the whole pin back in. Again, it's fine. You can do it that way. Just this way, at least, the pin is always locked in and you don't have to worry about it flying across the room. So let's say you need more than that adjustment. You need to remove a couple of links. So you put it on your wrist and you'll probably do it a couple of times to figure out how many links you need to remove. One thing you do want to be aware of, that if you're removing more than one link, you want to stagger it between both sides. If you're removing two links, you want to take them out, one out of each side. Three links, two out of one side, one out of the other. You want to try to, when you wear the watch, you want to try to keep the clasp, this part, centered on the bottom of your wrist so that the watch head doesn't flop around. So that'll keep the watch head centered on the top of your wrist. So you figure out how many links you need to remove and then you start the surgery. So like I said, I have a few tools to do the job. Let's go over those tools really quick. I probably should have done that in the beginning. I have two spring bar tools, one full size. It's got the fork on the end for removing the spring bars for a strap, and it's got a pusher on the other end. This end actually flips around, and it's a fine fork that you can use for smaller work. I've got a smaller version of the same tool. It's got a fork on one end and a point on the other. You just saw me use it. I'll put links to all this stuff down below so you can check it on the website and look at it. I have this pin pushing device. It's kind of like a vise, a clamp. As you screw and unscrew it, the pin goes in and out, and that will knock the push pin in or out. And again, I'll show you that in a minute. And the last one is probably the most professional. Would be a block hammer. I have a series of three punches of different diameters, and they like to stick to my gloves. The hammer is nylon on one side, and it's metal on the other. I actually believe it's nickel-plated brass. So both sides are fairly soft, so when you're hammering against the watch, obviously you use the nylon most of the time. If you hit the bracelet, you won't mar it. So let's go through each one. I'm going to start with the most basic and then work up. In my opinion, the most basic is this guy, this pin pusher. So what you do is you'll flip the watch over and you'll look at the links and you'll see an arrow printed on the center link. And hopefully that arrow means that's the direction that you want to push the pin out of. Now they're one-way pins. The head is large at one end and smaller at the other. And now if you look at the weight, at the direction we're pushing from, if you actually look, you'll see the tip of a pin. If you look on the other side, I know this throws a lot of people off. You'll see it's got like a little slot in it. And I know people think this means it's a screwdriver slot. It's not. A screwdriver slot is extremely, extremely prominent. It's obvious. This is not obvious. You can put a screwdriver in there and do whatever you want. You're not going to turn anything. So all you have to do is take the pusher, push it in the slot, and it wants me to push. Whoops. Hey, you know, it's a good thing I just did that. You see there's no arrow on this link? I'm not going to take it out. I mean, I can, but as links get towards the top of the bracelet, they sometimes get wider. And also sometimes they're permanent links. There won't even be a hole for them. You cannot take them out. But let's stick with the links that we're supposed to remove. So all the links that you can remove are all the same width. As you get near the top of the bracelet, obviously they get a little bit wider to meet the case. So I'm going to take the tool, I'm going to put it into the hole, and all I'm going to do is push firmly. And you see I pushed and it already popped out. So here is the pin. I'm holding with tweezers so I can get it right up to the camera, but you can hold it with your fingers. It also likes to stick to my gloves like crazy. But you can see it's just a bent pin. It's bent on the far left. It's overlapped on itself, and then the end is kind of canted out a little bit into a little angle. So it's bent on this end, and then it goes straight on itself, and then see, they've bent the ends out a little bit, so that provides the friction, this jut out here. It's nothing more than a cotter pin, really. So it's kind of an inexpensive item, and they do, you know, they can lose their compression over time. I have sized watches where the pin literally just falls out. But what's important to note here is that this is the end, it's smaller. When you put the bracelet back together, this is the end that goes in first. So let's put the bracelet back together, and then I'll show you how to do it with the other two tools. Again, I think this is the most basic tool. I think most people have a tool like this. So I'm going to, let's assume, you obviously if you're removing links, you do this a couple more times. You do it again to this pin, and then the whole link falls out. And then you put the bracelet back together. Let's assume that we've taken out the links we have to, and now we're going to put the watch back together. So we check out the arrows, and the arrows are down. Now remember, down is the direction of removal. So opposite the arrow, then, is the direction of insertion. So I need a third hand here. I don't have one. But I'm just going to stick the pin through the link, and there it goes in. And so now that is the wider end of the pin. And it does not fit in the hole because it's bent out a little bit. So it needs a little shove. And that shove can be anything. But again, since we're just using this tool, I'll just use this and I'll push it in a little bit. And you want to push it so that it's just under flush. And that's it. And it's back together. Now let's say you're a little more advanced or you have a different tool set and you're going to use one of these. This is probably the best thing for removing links on a budget. This is something that comes in a lot of different flavors. It's this pin vise or pin remover. I've seen them they're big and blue. This is the small black one. What I like about this one, I discovered this by accident one day, is that if you remove the bottom, it actually comes with extra pins in it. So in case you bend the pins, which I'm going to get into in a second, you can just swap them out. And there's also a device here that you can put on the surface here to raise the bracelet if it's not meeting the pin correctly. But again, it's a very handy tool. It's small, it's light, it's inexpensive. But because it is a vise, mechanical advantage of threads, it's very easy to apply too much force. And if the pin doesn't want to move, or if you're not aligned correctly, you'll basically just bend this pin really easily, and you wind up putting a new one in. So I know a lot of times people say, I used it once and it broke. Well, it's usually the user. If you align it right and use it right, it should last for a long time. So what you're going to do, again, I'm looking at the bracelet. Sometimes people do actually remove this spring pin and open it up. It does make it a lot easier. What I'm going to do is I'm going to open this up all the way. I'm going to see the direction of the arrows. The arrows are going to the left. And I'm going to figure out which link I want to remove. And I'm going to just take the tool. I'm going to slide it around until I get the pin to stick in the hole. And I'm just going to tighten it ever so slowly until the bracelet is now forced against this side of the vise. I'll look through. And there I can see that's where the pin is going to come out of. Okay, I'm zoomed in on the back of the vise, and now I'm using my right hand to tighten. There we go. I'm trying to get the light right to tighten the vise more. And there it goes. Do you see that? I mean, I'm just using a finger, and it just popped out. There it is. It's ready to come out. So you can either grab it with a pair of needle-nose pliers. You can keep screwing this down as far as it goes, and it will push the pin out further. And then you'll pull it out, and then you push it. Everything else is the same. You do it again. You pull it out, you push it in, then you want to put the pin back in. You can do the same thing. You can put it in here, align it. That's a little trickier. You do wind up slipping. So for that, I do recommend using either the pin pusher like we did before, or a jeweler's hammer, or a punch if you have them. I have a bunch of punches. So let's get into the last method. You see watchmakers hammering on a block if you go into a jewelry store. So this is it's what I call a jeweler's block. It's got a series of cutouts in it, and all these lines in here, these crevices, they're all different widths. And you can basically just lay the bracelet inside the one that it fits. And then you can see it's open at the bottom in various places. And you just line the pins up, the ones you're going to knock out either in a hole or line it up to a slot, and you bang it out with a hammer. So let's try it out. I've got the bracelet here. Again, I'm going to open it now. It's easier to fit in the block when it's open. And I'm just going to lay it in. Oh, let's make sure I have the direction correct. Arrows are going down. See that? I had it backwards. So that's it. It's in there. And let's say I'm going to remove this. So now you we sell a toolkit. It comes with a bunch of punches. I have a series of punches. Any of them will work as long as they fit in the slot. It gets a little different when you have pins and collars, which I'll cover in another video. So now you can either push this with your hand, which I could probably do because I was able to do it before, or you can just take your hammer and you just give it a gentle knock. And that's it. And look at that, the hope the pin's gone. It's already out. It's all the way out. You would pull it out the rest of the way with either, again, pliers, anything, your fingers. Bracelet opens. You swap it out, you take out your links, you put links in, whatever you gotta do. I'm gonna do assembly again. I'm gonna find the direction of the arrows. So the arrows are pointing down, so I have to install it backwards to that. I get the other end. I'm gonna put it together. And I'm just gonna pop it in. And it's more of a feel. You gotta feel around. And once it starts sliding through, it's locked together. And then there, now it's just sticking out. So now that you have a hammer, everything's a nail, right? Now you have a hammer, now I'll use my nylon end, and I'll just give it a couple of good wraps. And then, once it's in there, you can use a punch, and just give it a gentle, and that's it. And that will bring it, just below flush. And that's it. You've done it. You've sized a bracelet. I've shown you how to do it with a couple different tools. You can now go and adjust the fine adjustment. The links will only get you so close, and then you want to use the fine adjustment to get there even closer. And that's it. Now you can wear your new watch. Again, if you're not comfortable with it, don't do it. Bring it to a watchmaker. Bring it to a jeweler. Whenever people call me on the phone, I always say, you know, if you need any service, bring it to a watchmaker, not a jeweler. Obviously, if you're sizing a bracelet, hopefully, you know, a jeweler knows what they're doing. But there are some pitfalls like the pin and collar system, which I'll get into probably in the next video. But a straight friction pin, this is simple stuff. You pick up, you know, one of these tools for less than $10. You can change straps with it. You can size bracelets. The tips are replaceable in case you break a tip. Tips like a dollar or two, replace the tip. Something like this also under $10. And then the block and the hammer, you know, comes in a kit that we sell for around $30, a zippered pouch. It comes with punches, screwdrivers, tweezers, a whole bunch of stuff. Case openers, polishing claws, et cetera, et cetera. So anyways, this has been Mark from LongIslandWatch.com showing you how to resize a standard pin bracelet. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to our channel if you have not done so yet. If you have any questions or comments, put them down below, and I'll be sure to address them as soon as I can. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.